الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربي زدني علما ربي زدني علما ربي زدني علما آمين يا رب العالمين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to a yet another exciting course from Team CIFIA. This course content has been created under the guidance of Sheikh Mir Asadullah Qadri, and I am a member of Team CIFIA, going to be your trainer today. Together, you and I will go into this exciting journey of learning about this important concept of Sahih Iman. So, welcome aboard. Hadhrat Mohammad Abdul Qadeer Siddiqui, Hasrat, rahmatullah alayhi. This course content is divided into the following lectures. Introduction. I had the opportunity to know Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi ever since my birth. He was the sheikh with whose right finger I first tasted the honey as a newborn, and he is the one who gave me my name and took me into Qadri Silsila right after my birth. My childhood was spent under his watchful eyes as my father was his murid and khalifa. Later, I spent a lot of time in the company of his sons. I received khilafa from his son and successor, Hadhrat Hussein Shujauddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, in 1995. Under his guidance and later under the guidance of his younger brother, Hadhrat Ghaus Muhyiddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, I rendered Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi's books into English language. When people read these books, they will surely be impressed from the vastness of his knowledge and spiritual eminence and will agree that he was indeed the ocean of knowledge of his time. A brief account of his life is provided in this course. Sheikh Mir Asadullah Qadri. Lineage. Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi was the direct descendant of Khalifa Rashid Amir al-Mu'mineen Hadhrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. In 28th generation, his lineage meets with Hadhrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu from father's side. From his mother's side, his genealogical lineage meets with Hadhrat Imam Hussain radiyallahu ta'ala anhu in 32nd generation. This way, Sheikh is Siddiqui al-Husayni. Ancestors. The ancestors of Hadhrat Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi lived in Hyderabad, Dakkan, for over 200 years. Before that, it is reported that they lived in Ahmedabad, Gujarat, India. It is reported that his great-grandfather, Abdul Ghafur Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, was a well-known sheikh of Qadriya order. He lived in Ahmedabad, Gujarat, India. He asked his son, Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, to migrate to Dakkan, South India. Abdul Qadir rahmatullah alayhi reached Aurangabad at a time when Asif Jah II, Mir Nizam Ali Khan, was the ruler of Hyderabad state. At that time, Aurangabad was the capital of Hyderabad, Dakkan. His hard work earned him the title of Mohiuddin Dola Nawab Qadir Khan from the ruler. He died at the age of 80 in 1774 AD. Muhammad Ali Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, the son of Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, migrated from Aurangabad to Hyderabad along with Nizam Asif Jah II when the capital of the state was changed to Hyderabad. In Hyderabad, he lived in the company of Sufi Sheikh Ji Hali rahmatullah alayhi. Muhammad Fadlullah Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, the son of Muhammad Ali Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, was born in 1812 AD. He memorized Quran and took Baya in Naqshbandi order. He was later appointed as Chief Justice in Hyderabad state. He died in 1866 AD. Muhammad Fadlullah Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi had 6 sons and 4 daughters. His second son's name was Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, who was born in 1835 AD. He was very learned scholar and wrote many books. He took Baya on the hands of Shah Saadullah rahmatullah alayhi and received Khilafah from Shah Abdul Ghani Naqshbandi Mujaddidi Rahmatullah Alayhi, the son of Shah Waliullah Muhaddad Dahalvi Rahmatullah Alayhi. He was also appointed as Chief Justice of Hyderabad State. Abdul Qadir Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi married the daughter of Hadhrat Mir Parvarish Ali Badshah Husaini Qadri Rahmatullah Alayhi, who lived in Qazipura area in Hyderabad. Sheikh Muhammad Siddiq Mehboob Allah Qadri Rahmatullah Alayhi was the son of Hadhrat Mir Parvarish Ali Badshah Husaini Qadri Rahmatullah Alayhi. Abdul Qadir Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi had two sons and one daughter. Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi was the elder son. Blessed birth. Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi was born on Friday, October 12, 1871, Rajab 27, 1288 AH, in Hyderabad, in the house of his maternal grandfather, Hadhrat Sayyid Muhammad Badshah Husaini, alias Mir Parvarish Ali Rahmatullah Alayhi, in Khazipura locality. On his birth, Nizam Asif Jah 6, Mir Mehboob Ali Khan, gave him a stipend of Rs. 100 per month as Mansab, which continued till the fall of Hyderabad State in 1948. Education. Sheikh Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi was taught by his father, Hadhrat Abdul Qadir Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi, in his childhood. He also received education from his Sheikh Muhammad Siddiqui Mehboobullah, 1847 to 1896, Rahmatullah Alayhi, who was his maternal uncle and Sheikh-e-Tariqat. In 1879, when the Sheikh was 8 years old, he did Hajj along with his parents and maternal uncle, Sheikh Muhammad Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi, who later became his Sheikh. Sheikh Muhammad Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi died on April 30, 1896 and was buried at Khazipura locality in Hyderabad. Sheikh Abdul Qadir Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi joined Madarsa Mehboobiya Maulana Muhammad Zama for his elementary education and later joined Darul Uloom Hyderabad for higher secondary education. Darul Uloom was established in 1856 and was affiliated to Punjab University under British India. He learned Arabic, exegesis of Quran, Hadith, Islamic literature, logic, philosophy, etc. at Darul Uloom. He studied Dars-e-Nizami from Sheikh Abdus Samad, Hadith from Maulana Sayyid Umar, and recitation of Quran from Sayyid Tonsi. He also learned Indian medicine from Dr. Mansur Ali Khan, science from Babu Amrit Lal, and poetry from Hadhrat Muhammad Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi. Later, he completed Maulvi Fadil and Munshi Fadil from Punjab University and topped the university and was awarded gold medal. Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi's mother died in the year 1887 and father died in 1911. Sheikh married when he was 15 years old. After the death of his wife, Sheikh married again. He had 15 sons and 15 daughters, many of whom are reported to have died in their childhood. Baya, Ijaza and Khilafa. Sheikh Siddiqui Rahmatullah Alayhi took Baya on the hands of Sheikh Muhammad Siddiqui Mehboobullah Rahmatullah Alayhi in his early age and received Khilafa in 1887 when he was 16 years old. He had the opportunity to be in the company of his Sheikh from his childhood. Sheikh also received Ijaza and Khilafa from well-known shuyukh of his time. First, Hadhrat Khaja Mehboobullah Rahmatullah Alayhi in Qadri, Chishti, Naqshbandi and Rifai orders. Second, Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Rahmatullah Alayhi, his father in Naqshbandi and Mujaddidi orders. Third, Hadhrat Shah Ehsanul Haq Qadri Rahmatullah Alayhi in Chishti and Kamali orders. Fourth, Hadhrat Sayyid Muhammad Husamuddin Mahmood Rahmatullah Alayhi, Sajjada Nashin Ghausul Azam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu in Qadri order.
Alright, this concludes the lecture. Take a breather and we will get back in a minute to continue this journey of learning. Thank you.
teaching. In 1896, Sheikh started working as teacher at Madrasa Darul Ulum, Hyderabad. It is the same madrasa from where he had studied earlier. This madrasa was affiliated to Punjab University. Later, Darul Ulum, Hyderabad was upgraded to Usmania College in 1910 and Sheikh Siddiq rahmatullah alayhi became the head of the Department of Theology. Usmania College was developed into fully fledged Usmania University on April 26, 1870 by a royal decree issued by Mir Usman Ali Khan Nizam Asif Jah 7, the then ruler of Hyderabad State. Sheikh became professor and head of the Department of Islamic Studies. He was scheduled to retire from Usmania University in 1921, but his services were extended for 11 more years in view of his popularity with students. He finally retired in 1932. This way, he was the head of the Department of Theology for over 22 years. Sheikh continued teaching after retirement from Usmania University. He taught Quran, Hadith, Fiqh and Islamic theology to thousands of students who used to come to his residence located at Malakpet area in Hyderabad city till his death in 1962. This way, Sheikh was involved in active teaching and research for 66 years. He contributed in various capacities in the development of education in Hyderabad state during this time. He wrote many textbooks that became part of the curricula of many madrasas in Hyderabad. Some prominent names of his academic students include, first, Sayyid Muhammad Badshah Husseini, the famous Sheikh of Qadri Chaman, Hyderabad. Second, Dr. Muhammad Hamidullah, internationally acclaimed Islamic scholar who died in France in 2002. Third, Professor Abdul Hafiz Qatil, professor and head of the Department of Urdu at Usmania University. Fourth, Professor Ilyas Burney, professor and head of the Departments of Economics, Usmania University, Hyderabad. Fifth, Dr. Sayyid Abdul Latif, PhD, London, professor and head of the Department of English, Usmania University, Hyderabad. Dr. Latif has translated the Holy Quran in English titled Al-Quran. This translation is available in the market. In 1924, Sheikh went for Hajj for the second time. During this travel, he visited Syria, Iraq, Palestine, and Western Saudi Arabia, Hijaz. After his retirement in 1932, he did Hajj for the third time. Sheikh refuted un-Islamic beliefs of deviant sects. Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi refuted vehemently the deviant beliefs of misguided sects. At the same time, he worked to create an atmosphere of peace and mutual cooperation between the followers of different sects for their welfare in this world. His efforts were comprehensive and two-sided. On one side, he propagated the rightful Islamic beliefs and identified and refuted the un-Islamic beliefs of different sects. On the other hand, he counseled different sects to cooperate with each other in worldly affairs for the benefit of all. In Tafsir al-Siddiqui, he refuted the beliefs of Wahhabis, Diobandis and like-minded sects in his Tafsir of Surah Al-Fatiha as follows. First, who can explain to these torturous monotheists, Wahhabis or Diobandis and their like-minded groups? How far can they be explained? If they had looked upon their soul and walked on the intrinsic path of Islam, which is related to the soul, they would have known something about soul, spirit and its related details. Forming an opinion about a thing which is not known, of which you do not have any experience, and then calling Muslims Ahle Sunnah, polytheists and apostates is indeed a daring thing. Second, O false claimants of monotheism, Wahhabis, Diobandis and their like-minded groups, you consider people calling Ya Muhammad and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to have the knowledge of it as polytheism and apostasy. To us, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is most dear. We call loudly Ya Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we are lost on the path, we call Ya Ghaz, Ya Khaja, Ya Naqshband, Ya Badawi, Ya Shazli, radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma jameen. Please help us. Third, the claim of having independent opinions in religious matters is not the sign of a sensible person. You claim yourself to be Ahle Hadith, Salafis, but are unable to read even four lines of Arabic text properly? Some unsound and deficient person told you that such and such a thing is in Hadith, and you began to believe him. without any investigation and research. Fourth, in the tafsir of verse 173, Surah Ali Imran, the Shaykh has declared Salafis or Najdis as a group of Khawarij who are overwhelmed by their shirk. Similarly, he gave a detailed account of Shia deviant beliefs in Tafsir Surah Fatiha under the heading, What are the stages of the destruction of Islam? As follows. First, Shia's claim of love of Ahl-e Bayt is not true. They do takfir of Khulafa-i Rashideen, members of Ahl-e Bayt-e Athar and Sahaba. The issue of Shia's subterfuge is the end of Islam of Shias. Second, Shia's objective has been total annihilation of the religion of Islam. That, Allah willing, has not happened earlier, neither will it happen in future till the day of resurrection. It is in Quran. We, Allah, have descended Quran, and we only will preserve it. Al-Hijr 9. Allah has taken the responsibility of preserving the religion of Islam. Third, who destroyed the Islamic governments? These Shias were the people. The Sultanate of Abbasids, the Mughal Kingdom, and in Indian states, the states of Mysore, and the state of Shuja'ud-Dullah, etc. When you look at Islamic civilization, these are the people who have been the cause of disturbances and destruction throughout its history. It is reported that the ruler of Hyderabad state, Mir Usman Ali Khan, Asif Jah 7, was under the influence of Shias who dominated his royal court. They were furious on refutations of their beliefs by Sheikh in his tafsir. They complained to the ruler against the Sheikh, and it is reported that the ruler signed a decree to banish the Sheikh from the state of Hyderabad. When the news reached Mr. Grigson, the member in charge of police and public affairs of the Executive Council of HEH Nizam, he asked for a report from Rahmat Yarjan, police commissioner of Hyderabad state, about the entire episode. The commissioner informed the Executive Council that some people objected and complained to the ruler about Sheikh's opinions in his tafsir of Quran and opinions in tafasir are tolerated by all sections of people. Also, Sheikh was loved by millions of people in Hyderabad state, and if these orders were implemented, it will create disorder. The ruler was briefed about the consequences of such an action against the Sheikh. This resulted in withdrawal of the decree. In the same way, the Sheikh has refuted the deviant beliefs of Sulah-e-Kulli, Deen-e-Ilahi and Ammanis. Read below the refutation and condemnation of these deviant beliefs by the Sheikh. These sects claim that people belonging to all 72 deviant sects are true Muslims, irrespective of their blasphemous and polytheistic beliefs. They claim that anyone who believes in one God, irrespective of his perception, faith and teachings, is a believer, and he will get salvation in hereafter. First, in Tafsir Siddiqui, in the Tafsir of verse 157, Al-Araf, Juz 9, Sheikh has written as follows. Some ignorant people have emerged in our society who say that do good deeds. It does not matter if you are a Christian or Jew or Hindu. You do not have to be Muslim to get salvation. Let someone question these Ammani, Sulah-e-Kulli people. What is the standard of evil and virtue with them? With us, the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam are the standard of evil and virtue. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows what is good and bad very well. It does not make any difference if, with their defective intelligence, they consider things as good or bad. The irony is that these people consider themselves as Muslims and also keep Muslims' names. What Sheikh is saying is, Ammanis or Sulah-e-Kulli are not Muslims. Second, he wrote in his booklet, The Vanity of Complete Human Being, as follows. The one who does not have correct knowledge, he neither has Islam nor Iman. When you have the right knowledge, you will act upon it and perform good deeds. The effect of your actions will reflect the soundness of your knowledge. What is illiteracy? It is a kind of darkness and obliteration. One who does not have correct knowledge here in this world will not be relieved of eternal torment in hereafter. If you do not have the light of knowledge today, tomorrow, after death, it will be the darkness of illiteracy, which is permanent torment. It is in Quran, the one who is blind about Sahih Iman in this world will be blind in hereafter. Al-Isra 72. The one who has correct faith and right gnosis is actually a human being. The rest are illiterates and animals. Third, in his book titled Monotheism, At-Tawheed, Sheikh wrote under the heading The Complete Human Being as follows: The success in the world of resurrection and welfare in this world of manifestation depends upon the rightful knowledge, correct Islamic faith, and divine gnosis. Fourth, in the same book, Monotheism At-Tawheed, Sheikh wrote under the heading The Need of Promise of Allegiance as follows: If there is a defect in a person's faith, Sahih Iman, he has lost everything in this world as well as in hereafter. He has lost this world and the hereafter. Al-Hajj 11.
Alright, this concludes the lecture. Take a breather and we will get back in a minute to continue this journey of learning.
Sheikh's spiritual eminence. Sheikh Mohammad Abdul Qadeer Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh was indeed the living phenomenon of a complete human being and a person of obligatory proximity with Allah. He also had the distinction in Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's subordination and was enthroned with the legacy of unveiling and eminence. Sheikh gave rosary bounding zakat of Asma-e-Ilahiyah extensively. It is reported that he recited each Ism-e-Ilahi over 20 million times. All his murideen were also required to do zikr extensively. The people who were close to Hadhrat Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh testified that he was at the helm of the spiritual hierarchy during his lifetime. Indeed, he belonged to the family of great shuyukh of Islam of all time. I have provided below two couplets written in honor of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh by his son and successor Hadhrat Hussain Shujauddin Siddiqui Izzat rahmatullah alayh. Sheikh Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh is dignified Wali Allah. His greatness is a blessing of Allah. Indeed, his eminence is established among the greatest awliya Allah. He loves Allah and he is a beloved of Allah. Therefore, he will be remembered by the people who will be benefited from him till the day of resurrection. Sheikh used to give bayah in Qadri Silsila. It is reported that he had over 500,000 murideen all over the world. Also, his khulafa were in hundreds. There is no record of his murideen and khulafa as they are spread all over the world. It is reported that some of his murideen attempted to record the names of his khulafa a few months before the death of the Sheikh, but they could record only 91 or 92 names. After retirement, Sheikh used to teach his murideen every day after Salat al-Fajr. Every Sunday, there used to be Dars al-Quran, which was attended by hundreds of people. Sama was held on 11th of every lunar calendar, and Khasida Burda Mahfil was held every 17th of lunar calendar. Every year, on 27th Rajab, his murideen used to celebrate his birthday, which was attended by thousands of people. Mahfil-e-Sama was organized on his birthday. His birthday and 11th and 17th Mahafil every month are continued at Siddiq Gulshan, Hyderabad. Hadhrat Khalid Wajudi rahmatullah alayhi. Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi and Hadhrat Khalid Wajudi rahmatullah alayhi were born in 1870s. They lived in Hyderabad for most of their lives and were great friends during their lifetimes. They are great friends even in their life after death. They both were at the helm of spiritual hierarchy at different times during their lives. Spiritual chain. First, Sultanul Anbiya wal Mursaleen, Rahmatul Lil Alameen, Shafi'ul Mudnibin, Ahmad Mushtaba, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Second, Imam al-Mashariq wal-Maghrib, Asadullah al-Ghalib, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. Third, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Sayyid al-Shahada, Hadrat Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Fourth, Imam al-Abidin, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. Fifth, Imam al-Muttaqin, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Muhammad al-Bakhr alayhi salam. Sixth, Imam al-Sadiqin, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Jafar al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Seventh, Imam al-Kamilin, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Musa Kazim alayhi salam. Eighth, Imam al-Wasilin, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Musa Rada alayhi salam. Ninth, Hadrat Sheikh ad-Din Maruf Kirki radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Tenth, Hadrat Diya ad-Din Siri Saqati radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 11th, Hadrat Junaid Baghdadi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 12th, Shayat Abdullah Abu Bakr Shibli radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 13th, Hadrat Abu Al-Fadl Abd Al-Wahid Tamimi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 14th, Hadrat Alauddin Abu Al-Farah Tartusi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 15th, Hadrat Abu Al-Hasan Ali Al-Hankari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 16th, Hadrat Abu Sayyid Mubarak Al-Makhrami radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 17th, Qutub Al-Arifin Murshid Al-Salikin Sayyid Abd Al-Qadir Jilani Mahbub Subhani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 18th, Hadrat Abdullah rahmatullah alayhi. 19th, Hadrat Abdullah ibn Yusuf Asadi rahmatullah alayhi. 20th, Hadrat Muhammad Ahmad rahmatullah alayhi. 21st, Hadrat Abu Ahmad Muhammad rahmatullah alayhi. 22nd, Hadrat Fakhruddin rahmatullah alayhi. 23rd, Hadrat Muhyiddin Ahmad rahmatullah alayhi. 24th, Hadrat Abu Bakr rahmatullah alayhi. 25th, Hadrat Sharfuddin rahmatullah alayhi. 26th, Hadrat Muhammad Mirza rahmatullah alayhi. 27th, Hadrat Ismail rahmatullah alayhi. 28th, Hadrat Abu Bakr Salam rahmatullah alayhi. 29th, Hadrat Ahmad ibn Musa rahmatullah alayhi. 30th, Hadrat Junaid Yamani rahmatullah alayhi. 31st, Hadrat Abdul Qadir rahmatullah alayhi. 32nd, Hadrat Sirajuddin rahmatullah alayhi. 33rd, Hadrat Aminuddin rahmatullah alayhi. 34th, Hadrat Muhammad ibn Yunus rahmatullah alayhi. 35th, Hadrat Safiyuddin Ahmad Khashashi rahmatullah alayhi. 36th, Hadrat Abdullah ibn Ahmad Bafaqi rahmatullah alayhi. 37th, Hadrat Sayyid Abdullah ibn Ahmad Barum rahmatullah alayhi. 38th, Hadrat Sayyid Ulavi Barum rahmatullah alayhi. 39th, Hadrat Khwaja rahmatullah rahmatullah alayhi. 40th, Hadrat Muhammad Shah Muhammad Rafiuddin Khandahari rahmatullah alayhi. 41st, Hadrat Mir Shujauddin Hussain rahmatullah alayhi. 42nd, Hadrat Sayyid Muhammad Badshah Husaini rahmatullah alayhi. 43rd, Hadrat Khaja Sayyid Muhammad Siddiqui Ali Husaini Mahbubullah rahmatullah alayhi. 44th, Hadrat Muhammad Abdul Qadeer Siddiqui Qadri Hasrat rahmatullah alayhi. Biographical accounts. There are three biographical accounts of the Sheikh written in Urdu as follows. First, the book Tur-e-Tajalli, 367 pages, was written by Muhammad Jafar Hussain Qadri Qadiri rahmatullah alayhi, published in 1987. The introduction of this book was written by Hadrat Hussain Shujauddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, son and successor of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi. Second, the book Abdullah, 600 pages, was written by Maulvi Anwaruddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi, son-in-law of Hadrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi. This book was published by Hasrat Academy Publications, Hyderabad in 2004. Third, a lecturer at Minaj al-Sharia, Raisa Begum, did research on the life of the Sheikh under the guidance of Professor Abdul Hafid Qatil at Usmania University. On successful completion and submission of thesis, she was awarded MPhil degree from the university. Death. On March 24, 1962, 17th Shawwal, 1381 H, Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi died at the age of 94 years. His funeral procession was attended by thousands of his muridin and well-wishers. He was buried at Siddiq Gulshan in Bahadurpura area in Hyderabad. His annual urs is celebrated between 16 to 18 Shawwal every year. Sheikh's works. Hadrat Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi has written many books in Urdu, Persian and Arabic apart from Siddiq's exegesis translation and commentary of Quran in Urdu. He was a famous poet in Urdu, Persian and Arabic. Compilation of his Urdu poetry is titled Kulliyat-e-Hasrat. He also wrote an interpretive translation of the famous books Fusus al-Hikam of Sheikh Ibn al-Arabi rahmatullah alayh in Urdu, which received critical acclaim from Islamic world and was included in the curriculum of many universities, including University of Punjab, Lahore. Some ignorant people claim that Hanafi school of thought is the personal opinion of Imam-e-Azam Abu Hanifa radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Sheikh refuted this claim and has compiled a hadith collection explicating jurisprudential details of Hanafi school of thought to prove that Hanafi fiqh is based on Quran and Sunnah. This compilation was written in Arabic, titled Ad-Din, which consisted of four volumes: A. Kitab al-Ilm, Book of Knowledge; B. Kitab al-Iman, Book of Faith; C. Kitab al-Ihsan, Book of Virtues; and D. Kitab al-Islam, Book of Islam. Ad-Din was later translated into Urdu and published by Hasrat Academy. Ad-Din was included in the syllabus of Usmania University, Hyderabad, India. Hadhrat Siddiqui rahmatullah alayhi's works are a treasure of knowledge in Islamic studies. The formalists in the Islamic world have alienated themselves from this treasure, which opens your heart away from materialism to the intrinsic spirit of Islam. I have translated most of the books of the Sheikh during 1995 to 2002 under the guidance of his sons and successors. First, Hadhrat Hussain Shujauddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh 1909 to 1998, and second, Hadhrat Ghaus Muhyiddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh 1935 to 2011.
All right, this concludes the lecture. Before you go, you can find more information of many other Islamic topics like the one we discussed in this course at sahihiman.com/books. Hundreds of books available explaining multiple Islamic topics up for grabs for free. So do check it out. Thank you for signing up for this course. We hope you had a great time learning about this important topic as we had preparing this course for you. See you again for another exciting learning experience at the Correct Islamic Faith International Academy. Until then, it's goodbye from us at Team CIFIA.